Sometimes it's the easiest things that make the most impact. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you something I call reverse dodge and burn. So here's an image that has some areas that are too dark and some areas that are too light. Generally speaking, we lighten and darken those areas when we dodge and burn, but we're going to do the opposite. We're going to recover. Right click, convert the layer to a smart object. This will make it non-destructive. Now we're going to choose image adjustments and let's lay down our base. We're going to choose shadow highlights. Choose show more options. So right now we're looking at the shadow area here. When we look at it there, it's too dark. So let's lighten up that shadow area. Pull the tone back and get it so it's just hitting the areas we want. As we move it to the right, it takes up midtones. As we move to the left, just the shadows. And the radius does some tone mapping. Get it where it looks natural. Over here, it's a little bright. So we're going to recover the highlights. So let's pull this down. Don't worry about it being overdone. We're just setting the overall tonality. We want to get some of the midtones in there. Adjust the radius so we don't see halos. Pull the color back. The color is saturation. Click OK. Okay, right now the image is looking very artificial. This is just the first step. What we wanted to do is open up the detail in the shadows and the highlights. Now what we want to do is just slowly brush them in and blend them in where we want them. Choose the layer mask. Press Command-I, Control-I on Mac, or hit the invert button. Turns it black, hides the contents. Grab your brush. Make sure we've got white for the foreground color. And drop your flow somewhere below 10. Left bracket key will make the brush smaller. Right bracket key will make it bigger. And now we can just slowly start to blend in the area exactly where we want it. And notice with that low flow, rather than just coming out even everywhere, we can determine exactly how much of that effect that we want to put exactly where we want it. So I'm going to keep a vignette around the edges. Let's open up the background a little bit more on those trees. So where it's dark, this is going to lighten. Where it's too light, like my face, it's going to darken because of the shadow highlight. There's before and there's after. So instead of lightening and darkening our images, what we're doing is we're recovering the highlight or the shadow detail exactly the areas we want and just as much as we want so we can really fine craft these images and make them look much more realistic than just blasting them with shadow highlight. So I'm curious your thoughts on this idea, if it's something you think you would use, and also let me know what you guys would like to learn. Drop it in the comments underneath. And if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Consider hitting that subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And if you guys like this, do me a favor, hit that thumbs up. It helps us with the YouTube algorithm. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.